Hello students, we shall look at the numericals on module 1, that is temperature scales. We will see some 8 to 10 numericals, and before we start the numericals, we will see how to solve the numericals, because there will be a small derivation for the temperature relation, and then subsequently we will solve the numericals. Now you can see like temperature scales, consider a thermometric property X such that a temperature T is a linear function of the property. Now if you want me to show it, I'd like to show, suppose suppose I wish to show it on so this is x axis, this is like temperature. Okay, now this becomes A, this becomes A, and this is slope. Okay, this is x. So you can see that x is a thermometric property and is a linear function and of this property, that is temperature. Okay, T is equal to A plus Bx, where A and B are constants which are obtained by measuring x at two known temperatures. So what are the known temperatures? As you all know, one is the ice point, that is 0 degree centigrade. Second is the steam point, that is 100 degree centigrade. So ice point we will represent as xi, and the steam point we will represent it as xs. Okay, now the equation is T, temperature is equal to A plus Bx. Fine. So that is equation 1. Now we found, we know that ice point Xi is equal to 0 degree centigrade, steam point Xs is equal to 100 degree centigrade. So substituting this value of Xi and Xs in the equation 1, okay, we get at steam point means T is 100 degree centigrade, is equal to A plus Bxs, because here it is steam point. That is equation 2 now. And ice point 0, that is ice point is 0 degree centigrade, is equal to A plus Bxi. Xi is ice point. So if you subtract this second equation from the first equation, 100 minus 0, you will get it 100. A gets cancelled because it is there in both the equation, and Bxs minus Bxi you will get. Again here B is common, so we will take out the B. The B that is equation is equal to B into in bracket Xs minus Xi. So this is the first part. So now you can see B is equal to 100 divided by Xs minus Xi. So now we have got the value of B. Let us consider it as equation 4. B is equal to 100 divided by Xs minus Xi. Now substituting this value of B in the equation,
we'll see A plus B xi is equal to 0. Now, if I take ice point equation relationship, at ice point 0 is equal to A plus B xi. Okay. So, A is equal to minus B xi. I take the B xi on the right hand side, it becomes A is equal to minus B xi. So, that is equal to, now substituting the value of B here. B we know is 100 divided by xs minus xi. So, what we get? A is equal to minus 100 divided by xs minus xi. Entire thing into xi because it is minus b xi. So, considering all these equations 1, 4 and 5. Now, we got the value of 1 is t is equal to a plus bx. This is a linear relationship. Then equation 4 is the value of b. That is b is equal to 100 divided by xs minus xi. And 5 is value of a. That is minus 100 xi divided by xs minus xi. So, t is equal to a plus bx. Now, substituting value of a and b in this is equal to minus 100 xi divided by xs minus xi. Plus 100x divided by xs minus xi. So, you can see on the right hand side xs minus xi is common in both the denominator. So, we will take it common. Top 100 is common. Okay. And this minus 100 I will take it to the right side. So, I will rewrite it. Temperature in degree centigrade is equal to 100 x minus xi divided by xs minus xi. So, this relationship degree centigrade temperature is equal to 100 in bracket x minus xi, where x is the unknown temperature, xi is the ice point, xs is the steam point. We will use this relationship to find the unknown temperature.
Hello students, we look at the first numerical. The length of a mercury column in a certain mercury in glass thermometer is 5 cm when the thermometer is at the ice point and is 25 cm when the thermometer is at steam point. Consider the length as the thermometric property x and let T dash be the temperature on the linear Celsius scale as determined by the thermometer. Suppose we were to define a Celsius temperature T dash by the quadratic equation T dash is equal to A x square plus B, where T dash is equal to 0 at the ice point and T dash is equal to 100 at the steam point. Find the temperature T dash when T is equal to 50 degrees centigrade. I think in my previous video, I had come out with a derivation which we will be using in this particular numerical, because we will straight away use the formula. So, I just wanted you to understand from where we derived that formula. The problem here is there is a thermometer, mercury in glass thermometer, okay. When it is dipped in at ice point, it shows 5 cm reading. When it dipped in steam point, it shows 25 centimeter. So, the length is a thermometric property. And the equation is given by T dash is equal to A x square plus B. And this T dash is equal to 0 at ice point and T dash is equal to 100 at steam point. So, we have to find the temperature T dash at 50 degrees centigrade. Now xi, the thermometric property length, is equal to 5 cm. That ice point, it is 5 cm. Xs is steam point, that is 25 cm, given in the problem. And for the linear Celsius scale, we use T is equal to 100 in bracket x minus xi divided by xs minus xi. So this xi and xs are the thermometric property at ice point and steam point respectively. Here the thermometric property is length. Substituting, now he has asked us to find out the value for 50 degrees centigrade. Okay. So for 50 degrees, what I will do? We will substitute the values. T is equal to 50 is equal to 100 in bracket x, the unknown quantity what we are going to find out, minus xi at ice point, it is 5 cm, and divided by 25 minus 5. 25 is the thermal property at steam point, xs, and 5 is the xi, thermometric property at ice point. So this is a standard relation which we are going to use, and hence by solving this, 50 is equal to 100x minus 500 divided by 20. Solving, it becomes 1000 is equal to 100x minus 500. So 100x is equal to 1500, or x is 15. So this is the thermometric property what we have found out for the temperature at 50 degrees centigrade. Okay. Now we will come to the ice point and steam point equation. The given equation is T is equal to AX square plus B. Okay. At ice point, here they are given ice point, T is 0 degrees centigrade, is equal to AX square plus B, and at steam point, 100, is equal to AXS square plus B. So you have got two relationship, one is for ice point and steam point. Now subtracting the equation for ice point from the steam point, 100 is equal to AXS square plus B, minus 0 is equal to AXI square plus B. Okay, so 100 minus the second equation will make it all minus. 0 is minus, AXI square is minus, and B also is minus. So what happens? 100 minus 0 is 100, on left hand side. AXS square minus AXI square. So A is common, so I take A outside. In bracket, I'll put X, A, XS square minus XS square. This P gets cancelled. Plus and minus P, that get cancelled. Then you get A is equal to, solving, we'll have to find A and B. So A is equal to 100 divided by XS square minus XI square. Okay. So having found A, we will try to find out now B, constant B. In the ice point equation, 0 is equal to AXI square plus B. Therefore, B is equal to minus AXI square is equal to minus 100 divided by XS square minus XI square into XI square. Okay. So we are trying to find out value of A, we have found out, we are finding out value of B. So B, you get it as minus 100 xi square divided by xs square minus xi square. So substituting this value in the relationship, T dash is equal to AX square plus B. So a value is 100 x square, 100, this a x square, so I am multiplying 100 divided by x square minus x I square into x I square, x square, okay, plus b, b is here minus 100 x I square divided by x square minus x I square. So simplifying, you see numerator 100 is common and denominator x square minus x square is common. So it becomes 100 x square minus x square divided by x square minus x square. Now here we will we are going to find out the t dash for 50 degree centigrade. So that values of xi, xs and x we will substitute here. So is the relationship is 100. So x at 50 is 15 centimeter we have found out. So 15 square minus xi is 5 square divided by xs is 25 square minus 5 square. So 100 into 220 in bracket 225 minus 25 divided by 625 minus 25. 100 in bracket 200 divided by 600. So the t dash value at 50 degree centigrade is 33.3 degree centigrade. This is how you use the relationship and solve the problem. Okay, thank you. Hello student, we shall look at the third numerical now. BTD module 1. It is on temperature measurements. The temperature T on a thermometer scale is defined in the terms of property P by the relation T is equal to A ln P plus B, where A and B are constants. Experiments gives value of P as 1.86 and 6.81 at the ice point and steam point respectively. Evaluate the temperature T on the Celsius scale corresponding to a reading of P is 0.25 and P is 2.5. So I'll again once again read. The temperature T on a thermometric scale is defined in terms of property P by the relation T is equal to A ln P plus B, where A and B are constants. Experiments give value of P as 1.86 and 6.81 at the ice point and the steam point respectively. Evaluate the temperature T on the Celsius scale corresponding to a reading of P is 0.25 and P is 2.5. So the given relationship is T is equal to A ln P plus B. Suppose we say call it as equation 1. At ice point T is equal to 0 degree centigrade and P the value is 1.86. At steam point T temperature is 100 degree centigrade and P is 6.81. So substituting these two values of ice point and steam point in the relationship 1, equation 1. 100 is equal to A ln 6.81 plus B, that is steam point relationship, and ice point 0 is equal to A ln 1.86 plus B. Okay, so you got these two relation, equation 2 for steam and equation 3 for ice point. So I will subtract the ice point equation from the steam point equation, means solving for 2 and 3. What I get? 100 is equal to A ln 6.61 minus ln 1.86. 100 is equal to A in bracket 1.298. So solving, we get A is equal to 77. So what is the value of B? So substituting the value of A in any of the equations. Suppose now here I am substituting the value of A in the steam relationship, that is equation 2. 100 is equal to A ln 6.81 plus B. Therefore 100 minus A ln 6.81 is equal to B. So 100 minus, now substituting value of A in this, 100 minus 7.77 into ln 6.81 is equal to B. So B is equal to 100 minus 147.7, B is minus 47.7.
So the value of B is 47.7. So now we know the value of B, we know the value of A, and for now we can substitute in the equation 1 and find out the value. When that value of P is given as 0.25, and when the second, when the value of P is given as 2.5, in this relation, when you put the value of A, P and B, you will get the temperature T. So if P is equal to 2.5, then T is equal to 77 ln 2.5 minus 47.7. So the value of T is 23 degree centigrade. So if P is equal to 0.25, then T is equal to 77 ln 0.25 minus 47.7, the value is minus 154 degree centigrade. So this is how you can solve the problem. And here it is a very simple problem, because the relationships are given. When the relationships are given, then it is very simple. You have to only put it in like ice point values, steam point values, find out the constants A and B. Once you subtract that ice point relation from steam point, you will find out the value of A, because B get cancelled, and put it, substituting the value of A in any equation, whether ice point or steam point, you will find the value of B. So then you can easily find out the temperature at the given values of P. Okay, thank you. Hello student, we shall look at the third numerical now, BTD module 1. It is on temperature measurements. The temperature T on a thermometer scale is defined in the terms of property P by the relation T is equal to A ln P plus B, where A and B are constants. Experiments gives value of P as 1.86 and 6.81 at the ice point and steam point respectively. Evaluate the temperature T on the Celsius scale corresponding to a reading of P is 0.25 and P is 2.5. So I'll again once again read. The temperature T on a thermometric scale is defined in terms of property P by the relation T is equal to A ln P plus B, where A and B are constants. Experiments give value of P as 1.86 and 6.81 at the ice point and the steam point respectively. Evaluate the temperature T on the Celsius scale corresponding to a reading of P is 0.25 and P is 2.5. So the given relationship is T is equal to A ln P plus B. Suppose we say call it as equation 1. At ice point, T is equal to 0 degree centigrade and P, the value is 1.86. At steam point, T temperature is 100 degree centigrade and P is 6.81. So substituting these two values of ice point and steam point in the relationship 1, equation 1. 100 is equal to A ln 6.81 plus B, that is steam point relationship. And ice point 0 is equal to A ln 1.86 plus B. Okay. So you got these two relation, equation 2 for steam and equation 3 for ice point. So I will subtract the ice point equation from the steam point equation, means solving for 2 and 3. What I get? 100 is equal to A ln 6.61 minus ln 1.86. 100 is equal to A in bracket 1.298. So solving, we get A is equal to 77. So what is the value of B? So substituting the value of A in any of the equations, suppose now here I am substituting the value of A in the steam relationship, that is equation 2. 100 is equal to A ln 6.81 plus B. Therefore, 100 minus A ln 6.81 is equal to B. So 100 minus, now substituting value of A in this, 100 minus 77
into ln 6.81 is equal to B. So B is equal to 100 minus 147.7. The B is minus 47.7. So the value of B is 47.7. So now we know the value of B, we know the value of A, and for now we can substitute in the equation 1 and find out the value. When the value of P is given as 0.25 and when the value of P is given as 2.5, in this relation when you put the value of A, P and B, you will get the temperature T. So if P is equal to 2.5, then T is equal to 77 ln 2.5 minus 47.7. So the value of T is 23 degree centigrade. So if P is equal to 0.25, then T is equal to 77 ln 0.25 minus 47.7. The value is minus 154 degree centigrade. So this is how you can solve the problem. And here it is a very simple problem because the relationships are given. When the relationships are given, then it is very simple. You have to only put it in like ice point values, steam point values, find out the constants A and B. Once you subtract that ice point relation from steam point, you will find out the value of A because B get cancelled. And put it substituting the value of A in any equation, whether ice point or steam point, you will find the value of B. So then you can easily find out the temperature at the given values of P. Okay, thank you. Hello students, now we shall look at the fifth numerical in first module of BTD, that is basic thermodynamics. In 1709, Sir Isaac Newton proposed a new temperature scale. On this scale, the temperature was a linear function of the temperature on Celsius scale. The reading on this scale at ice point, that is 0 degree centigrade, and the normal human body temperature, that is 37 degree centigrade, were 0 Newton and 12 Newton respectively. Obtain the relation between Newton scale and Celsius scale. So Sir Isaac Newton in 1709, he came out with a new scale. And here at ice point, when the temperature is 0 in Celsius, the Newton scale also read 0. But at human body temperature, when it is reading 37 degrees centigrade, it is reading Newton scale is only 12 Newton. So we need to derive a relationship between Newton scale and Celsius scale. Many times this question was asked in university exam. So given is T in Newtons is a linear function of T in Celsius. We know when there is a linear relationship in my first video on the derivation, what I have done, T is equal to A plus BT. This was the relation we have used. T is equal to A plus BT, where A and B are constant, where B is the slope and A is the initial value when this X is equal to 0. So, using this relationship, Tn, temperature in Newton, is equal to A plus B into Tc. Tc means temperature in Celsius. So we know the values at ice point and steam point. So ice point at body temperature. We will use that equation 1 only and substitute the values. At ice point, when Tc, temperature in Celsius, is 0, temperature in Newton also is 0. So substituting the value of Tc is equal to 0 and Tn is equal to 0 in the relationship, Tn is equal to A plus B into Tc. So here 0 is equal to A plus 0, or A is equal to 0. So this is relationship 2. At body temperature, when Tc is equal to 37 degree centigrade, T newtons is 12 degree
Therefore, substituting this value in again equation 1, 12 is equal to a plus b into 37. 12 is equal to a, the value a is 0. So we put 0 plus 37 into b. So the value when you simplify, b is equal to 0.3243. So we found out the value of a, that is 0, and we have found out the value of b, that is 0.3243. Now we, if you substitute the value of a and b in the equation 1 relationship, we will get Tn is equal to 0 plus 0.243 into Tc. So Tn is equal to, Tn is nothing but 0.3243 Tc. If you just recollect, in my first discussion or that what I called as a derivation, I started with this relationship. So you can see the graph, y-axis is Tn, x-axis Tc, the small a, where the line intersects the Tn, y-axis, that is a, and b is the slope. So T Newtons is equal to a plus b into Tc. So basically you need to understand and appreciate so that when you get such problems, you are able to solve that coolly. They are very simple problems, but you should understand these relationships. And when it is a linear relationship, we are told that T is equal to a plus bt. As well as we have one more relationship, the T is equal to 100 into bracket x minus xi divided by xs minus xi. So these two relationships are extensively used. Thank you. Hello students, we'll see the sixth numerical. The resistance of the windings of a motor at room temperature 32 degrees centigrade and at full load under steady state conditions is given by 86 ohms and 100 ohms respectively. That is, when the motor is there and its resistance at room temperature, which the room temperature is 32, is 86 ohms, and its resistance at full load is 100 ohms. The windings are made of copper with a temperature T degree centigrade is given by RTP is equal to R naught in bracket 1 plus 0.004 into T, bracket close. If R naught is a resistance at 0 degree centigrade, find the temperature of coil at full load. So here the relationship is given, RTP is equal to R naught in bracket 1 plus 0.004 into T. Okay, and he has given the room temperature 30 degrees centigrade, the resistance is 86 ohm. And second, at full load, the temperature is not given, but the resistance is given as 100 ohms. Now he is, the question asks that you need to find out the temperature of the coil at full load. So again, a very simple and straightforward question it is. The resistance RTP is given by relationship RTP is equal to R naught in bracket 1 plus 0.004 RT into T bracket close, where R naught is the resistance at 0 degree centigrade. Okay, so we know that the given values are room temperature is 32 degrees centigrade and the resistance at that temperature is 86 ohms. So substituting these two values, 32 degrees centigrade temperature and resistance at 86 ohms, in the above relationship, we get 86 is equal to R naught in bracket 1 plus 0.004 into 32. So simplifying, R naught we get is 86 divided by 1.128, or R naught is equal to 76.24 ohms. So the resistance at 0 degree centigrade, R naught is 76.24 ohms now. So what is that full load conditions? So again, at full load condition, we will use the same relationship, RTP is equal to R naught in bracket 1 plus 0.004 T. Here we have to find out the R naught is given, that is 70, R naught is found out as 100
76.24 ohms. Okay. So then the resistance is given at full load as 100 ohms. So substituting these two values of RTP and R0 in the equation, we will get 100 is equal to 76.24 in bracket 1 plus 0.004 into T. So here we have to find T. 100 divided by 76.24 is equal to 1 plus 0.004.
Okay. So 100 divided by 76.24 is equal to 1 plus 0.004 T, or 1.131 minus 1 is equal to 0.004 into T, or simple on simplification, T is temperature is equal to 77.9 degrees centigrade. Means at full load, when the motor resistance is 100 ohms, the temperature of the coil is 77.9 degree centigrade. Okay, you can see the simple, I have in the left, you can see just one small sketch I have made. Just you can see that left side I have put the degree centigrade. So 0 degree centigrade, the resistance is 76 ohms he has given. Okay, this way I calculated. At 0 it is 76 ohms. But at 32 degree centigrade he has given it as 86 ohms. Okay. He has asked at 100 ohms, when the resistance is 100 ohms, what is this temperature? And we have calculated that as 77. So that looks linear, you can see, na? Here, both on the either side, left side as well as right side, the values are increasing. So this is okay. Right? So please understand, whenever you solve some problems, you can make out like this one sketch. And left and right side, you can put the value so that you can understand the relationship. Thank you.